Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain.
Hello, a very good day to you. My name is Sister Temi Tayo, and I'm a Christian content creator, and I'm here to share the Open Heavens daily devotional compiled by the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. Now, if you're visiting my channel for the very first time, or if you know me personally, you may be asking why I'm sharing from this particular Christian book. The reason is because the Lord instructed me to do so as I prepare to enter into the year 2020. This is my fourth year of sharing, and all those Open Heavens videos from 2020 are all loaded on my YouTube channel. My handle on YouTube is Temi Agede, which is right on the screen. I will encourage you to visit my channel to view the old Open Heavens daily devotional videos, which are a great study guide, and also to view the Open Heavens video for the current day. And I know that as you watch that video, you will be blessed, and it will give you a deeper understanding of the daily devotional. And while you're on there, please don't forget to subscribe, and the Lord bless you as you do. Now, Pastor Adeboye led me to Christ in October 1997, a few years back, when I was an undergraduate in the University of Lagos, Nigeria, in West Africa. And Pastor gives you a few scriptures from the Bible and a memory verse, and that helps you to understand the daily devotional better. Praise God. So, today is Saturday, June the 17th. Praise God. Saturday, June the 17th. And the title of today's daily devotional is Time and Opportunities. Very important topic. Time and opportunities. Praise God. And our scriptural reading is taken from the book of Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 to 7. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 to 7. Those three verses. And I'm going to be reading from the traditional King James Version. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 to 7. And thus goes the reading of God's word. Solomon says, "Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Be not wise in thine own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil." Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Be not wise in thine own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. Praise God. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. Now, that's the scriptural reading for today. Now, the book of Proverbs was written majorly by Solomon. And Solomon, apart from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, Christ is our wisdom. You know, but then Solomon, he gave Solomon wisdom above all men. You know, so apart from our Lord Jesus Christ, Solomon was the wisest man that ever lived. God, because God gave him wisdom. You know, and he's saying to us that we should trust in the Lord with all our hearts. Lean not unto your own understanding in all your ways. Acknowledge him and he shall direct your paths. Don't be wise in your own eyes. Fear God and depart from evil. So Solomon is saying that we should trust God with all our hearts. You know, trust God with your life. Trust God with your finances. Trust him with every part of your mighty destiny. Trust him with your education. In all your ways, acknowledge him. In all. Not some, not most, but in all your ways, acknowledge him. And he shall make your path straight. You see, when we acknowledge God in all our ways, that means we have a plan. We don't just come and say, "I told God." You don't tell God. You don't have the right to tell God, "I told God that if you don't do this." No. You don't tell God. You commit your ways into the hands of the Lord, and he establishes your thoughts. He's God Almighty. He's God. So you commit it into his hands and say, "Lord, look at this. I have now gotten a visa." Because sometimes you can have a green card, and you think that, oh, it's God's will for you to go to the United States, or you have a visa, you know, or they're giving you an indefinite leave to remain, and you think that, or there's now opportunity for you as a skilled worker to go to Canada or some European country, and you think, definitely, I don't need to ask God, because you're afraid that if you do ask God, he will tell you not to go or tell you to remain. So you want to do things your way. But Solomon, he's saying to you, in all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight. The reason you don't want to commit it into the hands of God is because you don't trust God with your life. Trust him. Trust the Lord with all your heart. Trust God. If there's anybody, the plans that God has for us are plans of good and not of evil, that we may have a hope and a future. God is more willing for us to be successful than for us. You know, so where your success is, where God is. Praise God. Your success is where God is. And, you know, as I read this, the first thing that came to my mind is Isaac, even Abraham. You know, Isaac, was in Canaan, and there was famine in the land of Canaan, and he wanted to go down to Egypt, and God appeared to him and said, No. Yes, there's bread in Egypt, and there's famine in Canaan, as there is in some African countries today, not just food farming, but every kind of farming, things are very hard, and he wanted to go down to Egypt, and Egypt is where God is not. Canaan is where God is, and he said to Isaac, no, don't go down to Egypt. You stay in this land. And so he, and the Bible says, Isaac sowed in that land and brought forth a harvest, and he prospered and continued prospering and became, until he became exceedingly prosperous, and how can you sow in a land of famine and prosper and continue prospering until you become exceedingly prosperous? Because God was with him. The Bible says, and when Joseph went into prison, he prospered. Why? Because God was with him. So prosperity is where God is. So trust God with your life. Lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he shall make your path straight. Now, the memory verse is taken from Psalm 90, verse 12. Psalm 90, verse 12, which is a psalm of Moses, and it says, so teach us to number our days that we may apply our heart unto wisdom. So teach us to number our days that we may apply our heart unto wisdom. That Psalm 90 is a psalm, written by Moses. Now, if I read that in the New Living Translation, it says, Lord, teach us to realize the brevity of life so that we may grow in wisdom. And I remember as I was reading Psalm 39, verse 4, it says, Lord, make me to know mine end and the measure of my days, what it is, that I may know how frail I am. Praise God. So David was saying, Lord God, teach us how to use our time wisely. So teach us to every day use our time wisely for the glory of God. Do you get? Because we don't have too much time on earth. Praise God. Time is quite, Pastor says that time is quite a difficult concept to define. One very simple way to describe it is that it's a river that constantly flows. It keeps flowing in a certain direction and carries everyone along with it. No matter what you are doing, time keeps flowing on. Therefore, when you don't do what you are supposed to at the right time, not only would you have wasted a part of your life, a part of your time on earth, but a part of your life also. And this is why you cannot afford to be lazy. Praise God. Pastor said the time is very difficult to define. We're limited by time on earth. The only person who is not limited by time is God, because he created time and stepped out of it. So he lives in eternity. He lives in eternity. A day is like a thousand years, and 1,000 years is like a day to him. Praise God. So Pastor is saying that, time is like a river that constantly flows. It flows, it flows. It doesn't flow backward. And as it's flowing, we are flowing with it. That is why today is June 17th, and this is the second week of the second month of the second quarter. And then you say to yourself, when was Happy New Year 2023? Why? Because time is going. You look at somebody and they're getting married, and you're like, I remember when she was born. Why? Time is going. Time is flowing. Time waits for no one. And some people, no matter how much they gain, when they get to a certain age, they look back and they think, where did the time go? What have they accomplished? The only time that is profitable is the time that we have used for the glory of God, to fulfill the will of God. And Pastor said, this is why you cannot afford, we cannot afford to be lazy. Now, what is laziness? Gloria Copeland defined laziness as the dominance of the flesh over the spirit. Laziness is the dominance of the flesh over the spirit. May God have mercy on us. Now, one of the things you must understand about the river called time is that it's carrying us along. It is constantly throwing, as it's carrying us along. One of the things you must understand about the river called time is that as it is carrying you on, it's constantly throwing opportunities at us. It carries us through these opportunities from the day we're born until the day we die. As you flow, you go from one place to another and come across one person or another. Each person or place comes as an opportunity. Hi. If you don't grab it when you are there, you may miss it forever, as the river doesn't flow backwards. When you understand this about time, you realize that what decides if you will be successful is your ability to identify and make use of opportunities. Hallelujah. Wow. So Pastor is saying that, you know, as the river flows, the river of time is flowing. 2020, 2021, 2022. So look at COVID now. This is 2023. COVID that happened is already 3 years ago. 2024, 2020. You know, time is just gone. I see the river is flowing. It brings us across people and places, you know. And those, the opportunities are coming to us daily. And Pastor is saying that each person or place comes as an opportunity. And if you don't grab it while you are there, you may miss it forever as the river doesn't flow backwards. And the only way we, I think the way that we can make the most of those opportunities that come to us is when we're in tune with God and helps us to recognize, you know, that we are in this place for such a time as this. Praise God. Now, Pastor says, when you understand this about time, you will realize that what decides if you will be successful is your ability to identify and make use of opportunities. Oh, God. And the reading is Ecclesiastes 9:11. Let me read from the King James. Very important. I returned and saw under the sun that the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong, neither yet bread to the wise, nor yet riches to men of understanding, nor yet favor to men of skill, but time and chance happened to them all. And in the New Living Translation, it says, I've observed something else under the sun. The fastest runner doesn't always win the race, and the strongest warrior doesn't always win the battle. The wise sometimes go hungry, and the skillful are not necessarily wealthy. And those who are educated don't always lead successful lives. It is all decided by chance, by being in the right place at the right time. May the Holy Spirit help us to be at the right place at the right time. Bible says time and chance happened to them all. May the Holy Ghost help us to be at the right place at the right time. Praise God. The Bible said that it came to pass that Ruth came to the part of the field that belonged to Boaz. She was at the right place at the right time. But it was not just by chance. It was by the walking and the moving of the Spirit of God. May God help us to be at the right place at the right time. May the Lord help me to be at the right place at the right time, doing the right thing. Amen. The river called time has boundaries on both sides, and you are usually in the middle. Occasionally, when God really loves you, he brings you in contact with the right person and tells you to follow him or her. If you are wise enough to obey him without question, then you will arrive at your God-ordained destiny. And this is what happened to me when I met my father in the Lord, Pa Akindayomi. I had a PhD in mathematics, which was a big deal back then. My father in the Lord could not even read or write. He could only read the Bible because of a God-given ability. Yet, God said I should submit to and follow him. And eventually, when he was going to be with the Lord, he wrote in his will that I should take over the leadership of the church. My salary at the time was more than the income of the entire church, but I obeyed. This is how the river of time brought me to where I am now. Somebody said that if I've seen any further, it's by standing on the shoulders of those who have gone ahead of me. Praise God. So Pastor is saying that, you know, the river has boundaries. And occasionally, when God really loves you, he brings you in contact with the right person and tells you to follow him. Because God has a plan and a purpose. And it is my duty to, it is my role to acclimatize, to make sure that I'm in line with God's perfect will. And this is why, you see, when you don't trust God with all your heart and you don't lean on your own understanding, you may miss God's perfect will and settle for the good and acceptable will. Because there are three levels of God's will. For you to be in the center of what God is doing for you, you must be in his perfect will. Praise God. And Pastor is giving a testimony about how, you know, he had a PhD in mathematics in those days, you know, which was very rare. I think he was one of the first people to have the, he's 81 now, and you know, he had this PhD in applied mathematics, which is really a big deal. Then it was then and it is now, you know. But then God led him to this old man, this man, this pastor, you know, and he was in the man's, I will encourage you to watch the movie Enoch. I'll put the link in the description box. It's a biography of Pastor E. Adeboy, who is 81 now. And he says that, you know, when he met this man of God, the Spirit of God urged him to submit himself to this man who could not read and write. Remember that he had a PhD in mathematics. To submit himself to this man who could not read and write. The only thing he could read was the Bible. And he did, you know. And eventually, when his father in the Lord went to be with the Lord, then he wrote in his will that God had said that Pastor E.A. Adeboye would take over the running of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And that is how he became the general overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. So he's in God's will. The best thing in life is to find yourself in the center of God's will, you know. And that is how, he said, that is how the river of time brought me to where I am now. Jesus Christ said, he said, I've come in the volume of the book. I have come to do thy will, O God. You know, this is life. Because you see, you can become somebody great. Everybody knows you. But in the eyes of God, you're nothing. And one day, we're all going to stand before God and give account. We're going to give account of what he has, you know, of our lives to him. What did we accomplish for Jesus Christ and his gospel? If you want to fulfill your destiny, rely on God to show you the opportunities hidden in the people you meet and the places you go so that you will arrive at your expected end. Ha. Praise God. Praise God. That means you must be in tune. We must be in tune with the Spirit of God. You know, Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And Jesus Christ is the word of God. So the Holy Spirit is the one who is our shepherd at this time. And the prayer point is, Father, please don't let me ever miss my opportunities in life in Jesus' name. Time and chance happened to them all. Let us pray. Very important. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you. We give you glory. Father, we want to fulfill our destinies. We want to walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing. Father, please show us the opportunities hidden in the people we meet and the places we go so that we will arrive at your expected end for our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, guide us with your eye. The Bible says you will guide us with your counsel and afterwards receive us up into glory. Father, Lord, guide us with your counsel. In the mighty name of Jesus, day by day, uttered speech and night, but unto night, short knowledge. Father, we pray that we will never miss our opportunities in life in the mighty name of Jesus. Continue to guide us by your Spirit. And Father, Lord, help us to be willing and obedient so that we can eat the good of the land in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. We will not miss your day, the day of your appearing in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for your mercies and your love. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen and amen and amen. I hope this blessed you. My name again is Sister Temi Tayo. And while you're on my channel, don't forget to subscribe. That really helps my channel in the Lord. And God bless you. And I can tell you. Come on!